and girls, welcome back to My Thoughts on Everything. So guys and girls, thank you guys for watching. In this video, I'm going to answer a question that is asked in the comment section. This is from before 1492. And the question is Curaçao, the Caribbean place where I come from, predominantly black? And the second one is, if so, what are we going to do in Africa? So in this video, I'm going to answer this question. And is it allowed for us from the Caribbean to go to Africa? I will give my thoughts on all of this. So guys and girls, welcome back. Like I said, I want to give my thoughts on this. First of all, thank you for the question. I really appreciate it that when someone wants to know something, if you have a question, just ask it below and I will answer it in a video. Okay, what is happening with Curaçao and the whole Caribbean, by the way? It is 95% black, perhaps even more. And what are we going to do in Africa? So this has a history to it, and also the culture and a few things, but I will start at the beginning. And everyone watching, can you help me get this channel to 4,000 subscribers by subscribe, like, and share this video. Share this channel to other people. Let's get this to 4,000 subscribers. I am a diaspora channel, a black diaspora channel, and I make videos for all black people. I give my thoughts on black matters, black topics. It can be everything, you know? That's why my name is My Thoughts on Everything. Okay, let's jump into the video. Indeed, Curaçao is black, you know? It's 99% black or 98% black. And this is the whole Caribbean, and I'm really, really glad and happy that, you know, it's a privilege, and I'm really happy with this, because if I see the people that are born in Europe or other places around the world, you know, it's an I'm really happy with it. I'm really happy that my ancestors, my parents, great grandparents, all of them managed to fought to hold it like it was and is. And this is the Caribbean. And now let's jump to what are we going to do in Africa, in Ghana. So the question is, you know, it's allowed, right, to go to Ghana, Africa? And if it's not allowed, let me know why it's not allowed. Leave your comment below and let me know. And if it's allowed, let me know why. Leave your comment below. So what is happening for us from the Caribbean and my island, Curaçao, but let's talk Caribbean because the Caribbean is almost the same. It's not like we are... It's necessary for us to go to Africa. It's not like we are not being treated good by, you know, foreigners or whatever over there. This is not the case. It's also not because infrastructure, organization, and jobs, you know, because there you have really, really, really good jobs. The place is beautiful. Like, you know, the place is really, really, really beautiful. So all of this is not the reason. The food is the same, you know. I have had a picture of something that I made a few days ago. We call it moro, but it's like brown rice with peas and beans, you know. We call it moro. The food is the same over there. For us going over there, it's more getting to know our brothers and sisters from the other side, Africa, where we come from. You know, it's our ancestors that comes from there. And most of the Caribbean people doesn't know a lot about Africa and the history, because also for the Caribbean people, they managed to keep this away from us. The people that knows it, it's like perhaps 30% of the people, 20% of the people that knows the history, but not all of it, not all of it. So for us, we also want to get to know our brothers and sisters over there, know the culture and experience it and start to make a bond, because it's also our home. And it doesn't need to be an obligation to go and visit your home, you know. It can be from love, you know, because you want it. It's a love thing. It's we really, really, really want it. We are not forced in a way, none of those things. It's something from that's coming from inside of us. And if you ask, can we go to Curaçao or the Caribbean? Yeah, of course. Of course, most of the Caribbean people goes yearly back to the Caribbean, or once every 2 years, because Caribbean is a tourism hub. So it's really, really expensive. It's really expensive. Don't be surprised if you go to Curaçao and one cucumber, you know, the cucumbers are $5, $6. One avocado, $10, $8. So it's really expensive. To buy land over there at the beach, you're talking about $500,000 for just a small plot. Not 100 by 90 feet. No, we are talking about perhaps 20 by 20 feet max. Max starts at $500,000 dollar USD. Everything, all the numbers are USD, so it's ridiculous expensive. And for the Caribbean people, Ghana is also a good place, because for the people that wants to build and make something out of nothing, and Curaçao is expensive, over there they can really make it a beautiful place, invest over there, because the Caribbean, they have good education, they have universities. If you want to get your PhD, you can go and do it on the island of Curaçao. There is a lot. So the knowledge is big, but there is not enough space and room to apply the knowledge in Curaçao. So people are moving elsewhere. Some are going to Africa, some are going to other places in the world. So I hope that you that it makes sense what I said. Leave a comment if you want to know more. I will answer it in the comment section. I read all my comments. If you want to know more about it, if you didn't understand something I said, just leave a comment. So in a nutshell, we do it because of love. We do it because of we want to reconnect with our ancestors. We do it because we want to add value. We do it because we want to empower. And I'm talking about the people that woke up and are aware. Just like in America, Europe, all over the world, the majority of the black people are still asleep. If you agree, let me know in the comment section. If you say, hey brother, you're talking bullshit, this video is full of bullshit, stop making videos. Let me know in the comment section below. I appreciate your thought. It's your thought. I appreciate it. So, and this is the thing, you know? And for me, when I discovered the Ghanaian culture, I thought, whoa, this is exactly the almost exactly the same. Only difference is like in the food. The Caribbean has a lot of dishes, a lot of dishes. And Ghana, it's really limited, the amount of dishes. But now that the diaspora is coming back, they will come with more dishes. You know, vegan, vegetarian, blah, they do that, everything. If you are going to start a food joint, restaurant, or whatever, let me know in the comment section below. And if you want to share what kind of food place, let us know in the comment section. I already know that there are a lot of people going, opening restaurant. I know the kind of restaurants. So I can tell you it's going to be booming over there. All kind of dishes. You know, this is one of the difference. And what more, the animal, the sea life, you know, there is a ridiculous amount of sea life in the Caribbean. All colors of fish, yellow, purple, green, blue, pink, doesn't matter. Light, gives light, no light, doesn't matter. It's there, you know, in the Caribbean. But this is because the Caribbean managed to protect their seas when there was a time that Chinese were fishing a lot over there. And also in the Caribbean, we have endangered species, fish species. And when it started to get to this point, they stopped it. You know, they stopped it, and it's not allowed anymore to fish in the Caribbean Sea. You can fish in the big ocean far, far away, but not in the Caribbean Sea. It's not allowed anymore. And the people, by the way, the people over there stands up, they go and jump in the boat, the fisherman boat. It doesn't matter if you're white, Chinese, black, blue, brown, purple. If you do this, they will catch you. They will catch you, 100%. Because we are sea people, you know? This is also the name of the Caribbean, the meaning. It is the people of the sea. We love fish, we love sea, all kind of things. If you hear the people from the Caribbean that bought plots where I am, and by the way, the email address is below. If you are moving to Ghana and you want a place to stay, you want, you know, a plot, something, I've added the email below. Send me an email and I will hook you up. Yeah, so, and if you hear the plans, how the Caribbean are going to work the sea and add value, man, this is why it's also important when you have people from the sea. They will enrich the sea life, the you know, the plant life, the herbs, you know, introduce new herbs or use the things that are there to discover new medicines. You know, work together. I know Ghanaians and Caribbeans that working together like this. Matter of fact, most of the Ghanaians and Caribbeans that I know, they work like this. Sometimes for years, you know. I have Ghanaian partners right now. Not one, but two Ghanaian partners. And we are working 1 year now, and everything is just going perfect. It goes perfect. So but in the future videos I will talk about these partnerships that I have with the Ghanaians. I'm also adding value. I have partnerships with Ghanaian people. You know, one of them has a business and that builds website, and the other one is doing food. Let me know if what you are doing right now to add value to Africa, or what you are already doing right now to add value in Africa, and which country in Africa. Let me know in the comment section below. So I hope that what I said, I answered the question to Miss 1492. I hope I answered the question, and this is the reason, you know, we are just coming to add value and guide who needed to be guided over there. We think about our African-American brothers, we think about our European brothers. I hope our African-American brothers and sisters also think about us, how they can enrich our lives like we do with them. You know, we are thinking about how we can do this, you know, enrich their lives. We are thinking about how we can enrich Europeans' life, black Europeans that are coming back, how we can establish a community over there, you know, those kind of things. And hope that you watching are also doing something now to add value. It doesn't need to be something huge or big or whatever. Sometimes it can be something really simple. Someone asks you, hey, do you know someone in Ghana or Africa? And you connect them with a person. You don't know if this person that you connected with, this the other one, is going to do amazing, big, great things in Africa. You will be blessed amazingly. You contribute a big portion of the movement. Just connect people with each other. You know, if you can invest, check where you can invest. Partner up with people over there. Investing doesn't need to be money. It can be knowledge. There are people over there with great ideas, everyone. Great ideas, but they need investment and a little bit of guidance. So, guys and girls, let me know what you think about this. Give me your thoughts. Give everyone your thoughts. Educate us. Let us know. Shout out to everyone watching. Lovely Dove. You know, I really appreciate you being here all the time, your comments. Shout out for Lovely Dove. Shout out to Frank Kwame. Frank, shout out to you, brother. You and Lovely Dove, I don't forget you. I'm thinking, okay, how can I enrich these people? What can I do for these people, you know? But it will come. The right thing, the divine will give me the right inspiration for this. And also more, you know, there are a lot more. Donnie goes in, shout out to you, Donnie goes in, you know, really love what you are doing, your videos. I watch your videos, brother. I watch your videos, so I'm loyal. Blind guys, wife, their life. Love for these people. Who more? I watch all the time, you know, Vanessa Canby is someone that really, I look really, really, really up to Vanessa Canby, you know, really, really, really a lot. Let me see one more. Stella Chanelli, love for all of you, all of you. Natural Ghana girl, look how this couple fights, managed to build their home there in Ghana. Amazing. Let me see, brother Nagmizi, brother, I don't forget. You know who I miss also is living my best life in Ghana. You know the energy. Lisa Betty, Shout out to her. You know, shout out to everyone. Shout out to everyone. If you think I forget you, I forget you. I didn't forget you. Okay, everyone. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for subscribing. If you are not subscribed yet, subscribe, like, and turn on all the notifications. My thoughts on everything, out.